ஸ்ரீ குருபியோ நமக. வெல்கம் டு அவர் ஆன்லைன் டீச்சிங் இனிஷியேட்டிவ் ஏகலைவா. கிளாஸ் 2, சப்ஜெக்ட் மேத்தமேட்டிக்ஸ் அண்ட் டாபிக் கெப்பாசிட்டி. சில்ட்ரன், இன் யுவர் ப்ரீவியஸ் செஷன் யூ ஹாவ் லேர்ன்ட் அபவுட் லென்த் அண்ட் வெயிட் அண்ட் ஸ்டாண்டர்ட் யூனிட்ஸ் டு மெஷர் லென்த் அண்ட் வெயிட். இன் டுடேஸ் கிளாஸ் யூ ஆர் கோயிங் டு லேர்ன் அபவுட் capacity and the standard units used to measure capacity. Let's get into the lesson, children. See, children, do you drink milk every day? How much milk do you drink? Yeah, you may drink 2 to 3 glasses of milk every day, isn't it? And have you seen your mother using tumblers, cups, glasses and spoons to measure the things while cooking? Have you seen your mother using cups and glasses to measure water for preparing tea and for cooking rice? Yeah, these cups, tumblers, glasses are the non-standard units used to measure the capacity of the container. First, let us see what is meant by capacity. See here, you can see a jug and a glass of orange juice. Children, can you guess which can hold more juice? Yeah, by looking at the shape and size, you can say that this jug can hold more juice than this glass. So, the capacity is the amount of liquid that a container can hold is called the capacity of the container. See, let us do one example to show the capacity. Children, look at here. Here I have a glass. I have a glass and a water bottle. See, I am going to pour the water from this bottle into this glass. Look at here, what happens? See, the water started overflowing and fell out of the glass. This shows that the capacity of this bottle is more than the capacity of this glass. The amount of water that this glass can hold is the capacity of this glass, and the amount of water that this bottle can hold is the capacity of the bottle. See, children, now let us see what are the standard units used to measure capacity. Children, I said that we'll be using cups, glasses and tumblers at home to measure the capacity of the liquids. But the size and shape of these containers may vary from one another. So, capacity required standard units to measure. Let us see the standard units of capacity. Liters and milliliters are the standard units of capacity. Liters is represented by this and milliliter is represented by this. And liter is the bigger unit of capacity and milliliter is the smaller unit of capacity. We know that 1 liter is equal to 1000 milliliter. See, children, these are the standard units used to measure the capacity of liquids and they are approved by the government. Let us see, 5 liter container and this is 2 liter and this measures 1 liter and this is 500 milliliter and 200 milliliter and 100 milliliter, and these are the standard units used to measure the capacity of liquids and they are approved by the government. See, let us see some more examples. A drop of water is about 1 milliliter. You would have seen a drop of water that is about 1 milliliter and the capacity of a teaspoon is about 5 milliliter. You would have seen the spoon used at home. So the capacity of that spoon is 5 milliliter. It can hold 5 milliliter of a liquid. The capacity of a cup is about 200 milliliter. That we are using cups to drink coffee and milk, isn't it? The capacity of that cup is 200 milliliter. See children, capacity of bigger containers are measured in liters. Let us see some bigger containers. Here is a jug, water jug. It can hold about 3 liter of water. And this is a bucket. And the capacity of this bucket is about 15 liter. It can hold 15 liters of water. And this is a water tank and it can hold about 500 liters of water. And this is a tanker and you would have seen these tankers carrying oil as in petrol or diesel or milk. And the capacity of this container is about 15,000 liters. These are the bigger containers and liter is used to measure the capacity of these bigger containers. And look at here children, here these are the smaller containers and we are going to use milliliter to measure the capacity of these smaller containers. You would have seen some medicines like cough syrup and ear drops getting sold in bottles that can hold a liquid in milliliters. And you can see here cup as well as spoon. These are small containers and they can hold liquid in milliliters. Look at here, this syrup bottle can hold 100 milliliter and this ear drops can hold 30 milliliter and this spoon can hold 5 milliliter and this cup can hold 200 milliliter. And children, certain liquids in markets are getting sold in liters and milliliters. Okay, let us see some examples of those liquids. Here, cooking oils are getting sold in pouches that can hold 2 liter, 1 liter, 500 ml and 200 ml. We can see that cooking oil is getting sold in cans that can hold 5 liter, 2 liter, 1 liter and 500 ml. And you would have seen the cold drinks getting sold in bottles that can hold 2 liter, 1 liter, 200 ml, 500 ml, like that. And children, the capacity of the containers vary with shape and size. Look at these containers. This is a bucket and this is a cup. See, look at which one can hold more water. By seeing the shape and size of that, you can say that this bucket can hold more water than this cup. So, the capacity of this bucket is more than the capacity of this cup. And let us see one more example. Look at these two oil cans. See, which one can hold more oil? This can hold more oil than this can because the size and shape of this can is bigger than this. So, each container has its own capacity and it varies depending upon the shape and size of the container. Hope everybody would have understood the concept of capacity. To receive our online lessons, please press the subscribe button and you will receive the latest updates. Thank you.